Hello.
Hello.
How's it doing?
I think that one's supposed to be serving for
a reason. I mean, either that was me, it just doesn't happen.
I just know all the other things are so kind.
This monastery was built by one of the high lama called Sherab Jungnet. He is the founder of the monastery, Shelu Monastery. So as there is as I told you before in the advice, the Sherab Jungnet, the founder of this monastery, he actually decided to build the monastery, and he don't know where he built this monastery, and he asked to the teacher, and he asked to the one of the teacher, and I want to build one monastery near this area, so where I built this monastery, and his teacher give advice to the founder of this monastery. He said you can use walking stick as for the bow and the arrows like that, and he should just over there. There's a small temple over there. You saw that on the way. Small temple. So the Sherab Jungnet, the founder of this monastery, he took his walking stick from down over there. It was landed here. So he decided to build the Shelu Monastery here. And also, you can see, before in this monastery, the Shelu Monastery, there is about 320 monks living here.
320?
Yeah, 320 before the 1959. And nowadays, there's only about 65 monks. Yeah, only 65 monks. And also, you can see with so many other monastery, the roof is not same as like the other monastery. The other monastery looks like yellow, golden, but this one is Chinese style. The roof is all the roofs of the monasteries are Chinese style. And there is also the very, very old murals in this monastery. A very old mural, and they're very they didn't open for the public. Because some pilgrims touch it, and so that's why they didn't show the public. So that murals are very old. How about this Tibetan ruin beings become, and the first cultivated, and some of the monastery, and there's many monastery in Tibet. So these also are the first construction on that murals, but this didn't show for the public. So
for the roof, is this the original roof and roof design from when it was built? Or is this more of a Chinese design since 1959?
I'm going to go to the house.
And that was all to that. Ah, I see. Yeah, the roof of this is before the 1959. The first construction of the monastery, the roof is like this.
Yeah.
That's why I asked the monks that why is the roof like the Chinese style. He said during that time, some people of the government here, so they decided to use this roof because when they use the golden roof, they have to much. They have to match here. Yeah, to match it to feed. And they have to use some golden roof. So that's why there is more easy to roof like this. So we decide to build that roof a Chinese style. Mm. So as over there, you can see a cypress tree.
Mm-hmm.
This is the actually there's no special story. This is also the first construction of the monastery. Where also this tree was cypress tree was on that ground. So they keep as from 1027 till now.
Wow.
Yeah, the same tree, the big one. I mean the big one.
The
others were after
the
reconstruction, the monks they planted the other cypress. So first we are going to visit inside the assembly hall, and then we can go on the upstairs. There's several small chapels where they have statues of the founder of this monastery, and also we can see on the wall a mandala. You know the mandala, which is made of the different kind of sand. The monks made a mat on the ground, so we can see the walls or the murals are very very old, since from 1027. Okay, shall we go inside? No, this morning they already finished the
change. Oh, my God.
German notepad he has. Next trip notepad,
right?
Next trip, yeah. 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 Yeah.
Oh.